raised in the admonition and fear of God. I went to church 3 times a week, but to escape the rod, I sat in the front row, journey to the land of Nod, only to awaken to a voice, praise the Lord. As I grew older, the willingness to enter with praise got replaced with thoughts of suicide and endless rage. Somewhere in my life, I took a drastic change from the norm. And of course, when I went, it led me to a fierce storm. In the storm, there were drug deals and broken homes galore. When I hit the storm, my family became one more. Added to the spin cycle of hopelessness, our happy home took a turn of turmoil and mess. Not to mention the poverty that bothered me constantly, telling me all that I couldn't be, you see, because of the numbness that I felt in my chest. Couldn't love anyone, I could only digress. At this point in my life, I should be kicking up dust and running around in freedom with all of my trust. And my family unit that would now hold me up, but instead I got shook by quakes of lust. Suddenly feelings deep inside from my past life sprung up in me in the middle of the night. And once conceived, they slew me endlessly. Then they tormented me and slew me endlessly.
Lord, I praise you, I thank you. You are so wonderful to me, and I will give you all the glory. You saved me from the rain, you raised me, now I sing, I praise thee. I'll give you all the glory.
Check behind enemy lines, I searched for escape, only to see my efforts turn into a fool's fate. Memories of my past life came to remind me of what happened to me through clouds of deceit. Pounded on like a rag doll and handled like a man. Had me looking for the Lord's footprints in the sand. Seized by fear, I acted upon instinct, not knowing that my actions would take me to the brink of impending disaster from joy and laughter. But my life story is in the hand of the master. My life compiled by thoughts of hate, manifested into acts of rape. I fell deep into the abyss of sin that darkened my soul and tried to do me in. I took all that one person could take in silence, so I acted out my aggression and violence. Paid it to begin, but progression kicked in. My enemy calmed again as he sucked me in to the system of liquor chases and felony cases. One hurt away from becoming a free base, the lust, greed, and pride and envy are all that I can recall being within me. Fast forward to end.
Lord, I praise you, I thank you. You are so wonderful to me, and I will give you all the glory. You saved me from the rain, you raised me, now I sing, I praise thee. I'll give you all the glory.
I've come to the final stage of my life now. A change was needed for me to stay alive now. Standing at the edge but afraid to jump in, trying to live a life that's totally free from sin. I wandered through my life in misery until that fateful day sometime in May. My father finally came to rescue me and take me away from the liquor and weed. I had a bottle of liquor in one hand, weed smoke in the wind, and a stomach full of Seagram's gin. God spoke to me passionately and clearly, and quietly said these words to me: that's enough, son, it's time to come home. I love you now and I call you my own. And immediately the high departed from me, and the sickness of the gin quickly left my belly. Then I called my job and I called my friends, and I told them that this part of my life had to end. I packed my things and headed due east, with my wife in the front seat and my daughter in the back seat. And the pages kept turning in my life, God took away all of the addiction and strife. And I stand to say with great assurance that God made a change in me, and now I know it.
Lord, I praise you, I thank you. You are so wonderful to me, and I will give you all the glory. You saved me from the rain, you raised me, now I sing, I praise thee. I'll give you all the glory.